Now that you know what Android resources are and that you can put them in different folders, let's talk about how you can actually access the resources that you saved in those folders. When your app is compiled, there's a tool in Android called AAPT, and that generates the R class. This is simply an R.java file, and I'll show you an example next. It contains the resource IDs for all the resources in your res directory. So for every resource that you added, now there's an ID to refer to it. The ID is in a format that is based on the resource type. So for all drawable resources, which are graphics, it would follow the format of r.drawable. For all strings that are resources, it would follow the format of r.string. And then the resource name, which is hello in this case. Note that there are two ways that you can access a resource. In Java code, it follows the format of r.resourceType.resourceName. In XML, though, it follows the at notation. So it'd be at, and then the resource type, which is string, slash, and then the resource name, which is hello. Here are more examples of different resource types and how to access them. These are just a couple of the common resource types, but there's many others. Just remember that in Java code, you always start with a capital R, a dot, and then resource type, a dot, and then the resource name. And the name is whatever name you assign it. And then in XML, you have at, and then the resource type, slash, and then the name of the resource. Let's take a moment to find all the resource IDs in our main activity Java file. I'm going to open up the find command in Android Studio. I'm going to use Command F, or you can use Control F if you're on Windows. It pops up a search field here. I'm going to search for capital R dot, and then click on Match Case so that it only grabs the capital R cases. The first thing it finds is this r.layout.activity_main_reference. This is interesting because we're referring to the activity main layout file. This is actually how the main activity knows to load up this XML file. Isn't that cool? Let's look at the next reference. Okay, in the displayQuantity method, we have a reference to r.id.quantity_text_view. So this is referring to a view ID, specifically the text view that displays the quantity. Hopefully some of the puzzle pieces are coming together. By referring to this view in the Java code, we can update it while the app is running to show this number of coffees. Let's go to the next occurrence. Okay, in the displayMessage method, we see a reference to r.id.orderSummaryTextView. Here it seems like we're trying to refer to this text view that displays the order summary so that we can update it with this message.